we're going to pull out some of the elements of this story structure, follows the process as we'll see in a second. Let's go over basic story architecture first. So when you first start writing and filmmaking, you have a linear perspective in that sense. Pretty soon you realize that both the beginning and the ending are the same, which is why we demonstrate story structure via a loop. We identify the classic beginning and ending as a state of perfection, which is loss becomes a state of imperfection, the loss phase, the limitations phase, very similar to the Garden of Eden being lost, and the process of returning to it is undergone. You can start there, or somewhere in between. If you do that, the events there tend to be referenced at later stages, as in this story. Most stories, such as this one, end with some form of state of perfection. If you don't want to do that, if you want to end with imperfection or some combination, that's almost irrelevant. The process is always the same. So you're always going to have transformation, change, metamorphosis, transmogrification, the various arcs, psychological journey. You're always going to have physical journey, and you're always moving through new worlds, which are physical manifestations of new psychological states and new versions of the self. Working your way around the cycle involves jumping through lots of hoops. Each hoop has its own set of sub-stages, which in essence are functions which may be performed, messages which may be communicated, the table, tangibles or intangibles you're going in there to acquire, how to construct those sequences. So for example, if that's the ordinary world, we know it's a state of protection, repression, fear of exit, etc. So those sub-stages show you how to construct those sequences. When you're here, you're not able to return. You have to go forward, grow, learn, mature, let go of your older limitations, come all the way around until you're ready to return. So that's basic story architecture. It's the fundamental framework that all successful stories are based around. And I go into that in great detail on the 2100 stage of journey transformation, movement through new worlds and states, which you can purchase off the website. So let's get rid of that. Let's draw another loop so we know now there's much more behind that than a simple circle would suggest. So we kick off, and classically we've got state of perfection being lost by the parent. It's done before birth, very much like the Jesus story. The parent is creating the damage, taking the anti-argument. And in essence, what we have here is Ego, who is Peter's parent and wants to destroy the universe, in essence, because everything is different. And that relates to the debate going on, or one of the debates going on underneath of the story, which I'll go over in a second. So you're kicking off really with meeting our guardians of the galaxy in the ordinary state, ordinary world. Our guardians are working for the sovereign. Our guardians are a bunch of individuals working for the sovereign, who are all clones of each other, identical copies of each other. And this relates to the debate, an argument going on underneath, put forward by Drax when you've got Peter having problems with his romantic challenger Gamora, and Drax says there are two types of people in this world, those that dance and those that don't, and you have to find those that are similar to you. So at this point Drax is taking the sovereign side of the argument, find someone who is the same, you've got to be the same if you're going to get along. And what we're going to do is we're going to disprove that, and Drax is going to go through this process, his own journey with Gamora, to disprove that, so are the Guardians. So initially in this battle with this interdimensional beast, when they don't get along, they fail to take the beast out, but when they do, they take him out. Classically in the ordinary world, what you do is you break a rule, and that is one technique, mechanism that forces you out. So we've got Rocket stealing the batteries, not conforming to the rules that the sovereigns have set, not being the same as them. They pursue him out, and then they ultimately take our Guardians of the Galaxy into the first threshold, which is classically represented here by a new planet and a new world. And one of the questions that the Sovereign asked Peter is, who are you? And encourage him on this quest to find his father, who is the same as him. In other words, they're encouraging him to be the same as them, find someone who is the same as you, because individuals, a bunch of ragtag individuals, cannot work together, cannot form a family, cannot form a unit, and cannot form a family. And part of the boon here is when, again, Drax says, we're all individuals, but we're a family. And part of the choice that Peter's got to make is choose who his family is. Is it going to be Ego, his father, which we meet in the first threshold, or is it going to be the other guardians? So in the first threshold, that's one of the tangibles that we acquire, which is Ego. We also acquire Yondu, who is separating from the Ravagers, not like them, being an individual, which is why he's exiled. But we've got the Sovereign sending him on a quest to find the Guardians, which is going to put Yondu on this journey to turn him around. But initially they're doing that because they want to try and bring him back. Be like them, bring him back to be part of the Ravagers. We meet Ego, we've got Yondu, we've got the physical separation, we've got Ego encouraging Peter to come with him, leave them behind, his friends behind, and he does when him, Gamora, and Drax go off and leave Rocket and Groot behind. They're beginning that separation, and we've also got the separation of Yondu from the Ravagers when they meet up with Rocket, and then the Ravagers betray him. So all of that happens in the belly of the whale. Past the physical separation is the deeper change, and what we're doing is we're beginning to reverse around, or we're beginning to start to prove the argument that we want to put forward. And what we have is our opposites, our individuals, coming together, learn to get along, beginning to become a unit. So we've got Rocket and Yondu getting along, we've got Drax and Mantis, and we've got even Peter and Ego playing catch there, and then in the underworld phase we've even got Gamora getting along with her sister. And so that in essence is the first part of the step change, and then the second part of the step change is the seizing the sword stage and seizing the intangible sword stage. So the literal tangible sword there is Yondu searching for the arrow, this magical gift, this weapon that he has that helps him defeat everybody and escape the containment. That is a classic function when you enter the past the physical separation. But the intangible sword is all our individuals working together, so disproving Drax's point of view here. So we've got Rocket, Yondu, and Groot all working together, taking out the Ravagers, who are all the same, in essence, minor versions of the Sovereign. Then we are into our underworld. What we're doing is we're learning a lesson. Classic things happen here, so you get buried. So we've got Gamora getting buried when her sister attacks. And then the lesson is put forward by Gamora's sister, who says, I didn't want to be like you, I just wanted to be your sister, I just wanted to get along. All the way around, we've got a quest here. It's an extension of the quest put forward here, and the choice that's got to be made: which side you choose. Does he choose his biological parent, or does he choose the Guardians as his family? At the stage of the Atonement, he realizes who Ego really is. Realizes the negative side of the argument, so makes that choice and apotheosis away from him. And part of the boon is making the right choice and siding with the Guardians, and the Guardians again becoming a family. And then what you do is you go into the final phases, and we take out the negative aspects of the argument. So initially we're taking out the Sovereign, and then we're taking out our villain Ego. We have a classic hand-to-hand battle, and it's all done as a function of the proper side of the debate, which is all our individuals working together. And then finally we have also Yondu becoming part of the Guardians of the Galaxy family, and in the end dying, which is part of the departure function. What tends to happen at the end is supernatural aids will depart, very much like Aslan in the Narnia stories. In each story he appears, acts as a mentor, as a supernatural aid, and then departs at the end. And then finally we return to our state of perfection, which is put forward by the uniting of our family, celebrations, fireworks, and the giving of gifts, very much like the Wizard of Oz here, where all of our protagonists are presented, or main characters are presented with gifts. Here we've got the giving of gifts also. So that's just a very basic breakdown of that story. If you want a detailed deconstruction, you can order it off the website. But once again, showing you that all of these stories follow this process of journey and change and transformation that I go over in great detail. The 2100 Stage Hero's Journey, Transformation, Movement Through New Worlds and States, which you can purchase off the website.